Hi. So, the roller skating's finished, and now the housemates have completed their task. But have they? Because on two separate occasions last night, Tim failed to turn up for the task. So, have they passed the task and got their party, or have they failed? It's July 17th, it's day 55, and this, my friends, is Big Brother's Little Brother. Over here, welcome everyone. I hope you're very well. That was a genuine fall. This is a genuine hard hat, let me assure you of that. And a genuine sentiment as I turn from one to two and say hello, welcome to Big Brother's Little Brother. And this is Little Brother's big news. Indeed, the housemates have passed their task and now preparations are underway to convert the roller disco into a 70s party zone. I think we can have a look at that transformation taking place live. As you can see here, there's our hard at work team turning it into something you'd be very proud of on a Friday night, I imagine. There it is. Absolutely wonderful. High octane movement there in the poor household. Okay, the housemates have been given 70s outfits and are preparing themselves for tonight's party as we speak. That was bedroom two. Let's have a look at bedroom one. Who is that? Who is that in the front? Is that Tim in the lead? That's Tim, apparently, in the yellow flares turning around there. Who's in the orange? Is that Johnny? Believe I'm just getting that in my ear now. That is indeed Johnny there. Fantastic stuff. All right, more from that. And as we go away from the house, Big Brother evictee PJ spent his first night out on the town. Now earlier we sent out BBLB's newest recruit to find out what happened. So it's over to you, Spencer.
Okay, thank you, Dermot. Excellent. PJ, what did you do last night?
I went out with a guy called what's his name, Spence, and Chris.
Chrissy.
Chris Moyles.
Spencer.
Spencer Smith.
Did you have a nice night?
Yeah, it wasn't too bad.
I'm going to go to Spain for a few days with me and meet Chris.
I'm all right, I don't know, I've got to talk to my mum yet.
So, did you take a lucky lady home with you last night?
The only person that was in my bed last night, unfortunately, Spence, was you.
Okay, fantastic. Well, that was PJ, everybody. This is Spencer for BBLB, yeah, news. Over to you, Dermot.
Indeed, and that was Little Brother's big news. All right, the housemates have been given a total of 19 tasks this year, which means that by the time they leave the house, they'll have completed more tasks than any previous series. Oh! But how successful have these tasks been, and what effect has it had on the house? Here to help us work this out is Outward Bound's trust trainer, Steve Howe. Like my jump there, Steve.
Yeah, great, Dermot.
And of course, PJ. Now, Steve, we're working out far more than PJ. I want to stress that before we start. Welcome to the show, guys. Firstly, the tasks obviously entertaining for us to watch, but the wider implications to the housemates themselves, and what are they?
Every task was an opportunity for them to do something about their personal development and to improve and be better next time.
Right.
You know, I spend most of my time watching teams in the mountains or on the water doing things and then improving. So every single one of those tasks they did, it gave them the opportunity to say, now, could I do that better? What am I going to do next time? Should I behave differently? So there's some big implications every time they do a task.
And I guess the kind of Pavlovian, you know, reward for doing the task right and so forth, you know, helps as well, right?
Well, exactly. I think some of them chose to use that opportunity. Many of them did not. They didn't reflect on their performance, essentially. I think they should have done.
Okay. How can you categorise the types of tasks they've been given?
There were some tasks that in which individuals can shine and some tasks in which the group can shine. And if you think about the situations where the group shone, it was on the poor side.
Yeah.
You know, and they got kind of really intimate with each other. They were holding the water for each other. They were physically, socially, emotionally involved with each other. And that they were mutually accountable for each other.
PJ.
There were other tasks where they weren't.
PJ, did you think, even though I know you hated the poor side because all you had was pasta and salt, to quote your good self, did you feel like you bonded more on the poor side?
Yeah, you had to bond because it was obviously it was more difficult to sort of, you know, do things, you know, you had to bake bread and boil water, so yeah, it brought the team together a lot.
Did you realise the task was so important when you were in there, or was there a kind of a feeling of levity about it?
Not really, the task to us was just something which just took the time away, because basically we were rotting until Friday, that's how we thought, and then when the task came
nice,
around,
I like
it was,
that.
You know, it was great, you know, just something to do.
Alright now Steve, we picked out some interesting examples of the way the tasks have affected or illustrated group dynamics. The first is Johnny doing musical chairs, let's take a look.
It's a close one, eh? I've got the answer which one you put the answer that one.
My brother decided this.
Yeah, it's the side between the housemates, fairly.
Yeah.
Who's on
the
seat?
Oh,
I'm on the seat.
Has everyone get up
who's
on
the seat? Who's on the seat? Yeah. I'm on the seat completely.
Who's my seat,
Jay? I don't know.
Oh, it's up to you two. Oh, on, you
it's up to you two, guys. Do you want to toss a coin or something?
Jay, John, up more.
Jade wasn't going anywhere. Johnny got up knowing full well that he'd be condemned to a week in the poor side there. What does that tell us about the group? What does that tell us about Johnny?
Well, it told me about the stage they're at as a group of people, because when you start making concessions like that, you're at that kind of norming stage. They'd gone through the forming stage, which is about ritual sniffing.
Yeah.
And we saw a bit of ritual sniffing.
That's when they first went in the house, right?
Yeah, that's right. And when Tim came in, we saw some of that as well. Then they went through the storming phase.
Yeah.
And we saw some of that, Alex and PJ, Adele and Jade, mm-hmm. went through some of that. Then they're in that norming phase. I don't think they ever get, and probably won't get, to the performing stage, which is the final stage of group performance. They're not going to get there, because at the end of the day, there's one winner.
Right. Why won't they get there? Because
there's no common goal at the end of the day. That's why teams work together. It's about having a common goal. And all these guys know that there's a single winner.
Is Tim at a different stage to everyone else, bearing in mind that he entered the house later, or does it not work like that?
Oh, Tim's gone into complete survival mode. He's kind of opted out from some of the issues to do with the group altogether, in my view. Having watched a lot of Outward Bound groups in action, he has got to the opt-out stage.
Opting out, owning shares, private. Yeah. Yeah. All following a theme here. Okay, next we have the Sandy Memorial Pool Walk, as it's now been known in legend, where the rich side had to complete laps of the pool to win a pool table for the poor side. See, here's a reminder.
I can't believe you've done it, it's really nice.
Something to do, isn't it? Yeah, but we both get something out of it, whatever.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, it's not going to be as boring either. You've got a pool table.
I definitely would have done the same, but I know from doing it myself how, like, monotonous and boring it is.
Adele seemed more keen there to watch Lee go around and around and around the pool than she did talking about it. But obviously a charitable task there. Does that always have a positive effect?
It'll have had a bonding effect there. It would have been very different if the rich side hadn't been so comfortable, if they'd have been more concerned with their own personal survival, if they had no food, no drink, if they'd have been not sleeping well. We wouldn't have seen that charitable sort of behaviour. It was just kind of easy for them to behave like that. Mm. But the bonding effect was obvious.
And of course, a couple of weeks ago, we saw Tim on the rich side when everyone else was on the poor side. Was he quite compassionate then? I know that wasn't directly related to a task. Well, it was directly related to a task. Was he quite compassionate off the back of that, even though he couldn't give you anything? Was he quite sympathetic, or did he just go, look, another steak?
No, not really. Didn't rub it in our faces at all. He was quite disappointed, actually, that none of us could go over and join him. He was actually quite disappointed that he actually won the task, to be honest.
Brilliant. OK. And lastly, roller skating. What did that say about the group as it stands, that Tim failed to show on two occasions last night, in your opinion?
Well, if you're thinking about teams, you've got to think about the task and the team members and the individual. And Tim's just gone into thinking about the individual. He isn't thinking about the task. He's not thinking about the other team members. And like I say, he has simply opted out. That's him gone.
Steve, thank you very much. OK, we're asking you today to get your creative hats on and call Big Brothers Little Brother to tell us what task you would like to set the housemates if you had a chance, as I lean over here and say, here's a reminder of those numbers. All right, guest time now on Big Brother's Little Brother. My pleasure to welcome today's guest and self-confessed Big Brother fan and comedy actress Mina Anwar. Hello.
Hello.
How are you? You're right.
Overexcited.
8 weeks into the series, are you still glued to the set?
I'm absolutely hooked. I didn't think I would be, because at the beginning I don't like watching people when they're trying to get to know each other. I find it quite embarrassing, you know, when they don't really know how they're going to be themselves. Very awkward. And I switched it off. I didn't watch as much. But now I'm completely and utterly hooked.
Did you feel awkward in those first couple of days? Obviously, the people you bonded with relatively early, like Spencer and so forth.
Yeah, you do feel awkward because you're always sort of aware and what people are judging you from day one. So I don't know whether you change your approach. But you do feel very awkward, yeah.
Okay, cool. First up, it's Tim versus Alex this week. Alex is a clear favourite. Can Tim do anything to save himself?
No. In my eyes, no. It's irredeemable now. He's done too much now, I think.
Can Alex do anything almost to
stop being so grumpy? I think.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, because I was saying, I think he's spending too much time with Tim. And if he severs that tie a little bit, and he can, because he really wants to have a bit of fun, I think.
Mm.
I think he's just, it's like that macho thing between him and Tim. If he just severs that tie, then he'll just lighten up a bit. He needs to lighten up.
Do you think Alex might be ruining his chances of winning that big prize by being so grumpy?
Yes. I think so, yeah. I think so.
Okay, now, and what do you make of Tim? Do you think he's getting an unfair treatment by the press, or do you think he's kind of bringing on it?
He's bringing it on himself.
Really?
Yeah.
Has your opinion changed of Tim?
No, not at all. I still think he's a genuine bloke. I think I think it's been completely unfair as being treated in the press, but I haven't seen any footage yet, so maybe my opinion will change.
But I think he's so blissfully ignorant, that's the thing. He doesn't know that he's being that ignorant about certain things, and he's supposedly very educated. Mm. Whereas you can kind of forgive Jade because you think, well, she's not been as educated, supposedly. But he opens his mouth and he just puts his foot in it all the time.
Okay. Well, guys, more from you later on, but here on BBLB, we've launched our latest investigation. It's time for Choir Watch UK. Hello, everybody. This is the moment when Tim alerted us to his musical past.
It was really funny. It was a school competition, like, in school, and everyone had to, well, not everyone, but, you know, whatever year, had to write a Christmas carol, like, Christmas song. And it was my gran and my mum basically wrote it, I did nothing, and took it back, and it was a sing, nothing, red breast, sing, 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 for today's born a brand new king, blah, blah, blah. And they, like, put it to music, and then got the choir sang it, and it was all to music. Sing, Robin Redbreast, sing, sing, sing. And then we went into international competition, and then we all had to go down to the Pebble Mill. Do you remember Pebble Mill? Mm. And one of the other groups performing there in a different category was Take That.
Mm. We remember Pebble Mill, Tim, because yesterday our crack team of researchers tracked down this little doozy. Take a look. This is the Christmas that Jesus was born. Not much of a mystery, but it all turned into a mystery. As it appears, when we show you out yesterday, we thought Tim was in the footage. It appears now maybe Tim isn't in the footage we have of that TV show. Here, hopefully to clear that, was eyewitness and fellow choir boy, Simon Rodway. Hello, Simon.
Hi there.
How are you?
I'm not too bad, thanks. How are you?
Thank you very much. Simon,
eyewitness
and maybe killer at the same time. That's nice to know. Simon, do you remember Tim being in the choir?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Was he any good?
No, he wasn't bad.
Good, that's good. That's
it was good. A long time ago and, you know, we were all forced into it, so...
Okay, I hope you're not making any judgment of the church there, Simon. Okay. Can you confirm for us whether he is or not in this video? Take a look.
Okay.
Okay, that's not him. That's not him. That's not him. That's not him. That's not him at the back. Not in the middle. That's not... There he is! There he is, surely! There he is.
Hang on, you're about 5 seconds ahead, hang on.
Okay.
No, that's definitely not him at the bottom. Definitely
Simon,
not.
Shut up, man. It's a spitting image of him. What are you talking about?
No, honestly, I swear.
Do you know who that is?
I can't remember his name. It's been on my tongue all day, but I just can't remember. But Tim was a lot, he was much taller than that little kid there.
Yeah.
And his hair was, you know, proper ginger.
Was it?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, this could run and run. But are you sure? Because I'm sure if we can just get, like, a split screen. Look, it is the same child. Now, yesterday I didn't think so, but now I've slept on it, I genuinely think it is.
Honestly,
no.
It's not, honestly. That kid there, right, was about, he's about 3 foot tall.
Yeah.
And Tim was just not like that. He was much taller and his hair was, you know, it had the ginger twinge.
Simon rules, he has to come on the show now. Simon, thank you very much, my friend.
Okay.
Okay. So, that was indeed Choir Watch UK, but I don't think we've finished yet. Are you a member of that choir? Are you the boy we accused of being Tim? Can you help up clear up this mystery? Do you remember Tim being on TV with Gary Barlow in a non-Take That context? Your call counts. The numbers are on the screen right now, ladies and gentlemen. Please get in touch. We only have 2 weeks left. Just over a week of Big Brother left, but the best is still to come. Here's a taste of what we have in store for you.
On Sunday, the 28th of July, Little Brother will be coming live from inside the most famous house in Britain. The housemates reunited, celebrity guests and exclusive gossip about what really went on. BBLB, first in, last out.
BBLB indeed. That's where the passion is, kids. Me and my enormous hooves will see you in five. Hi, welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. I hope we're all very well. Breaking news before we go into our producer chat today. Apparently, just had a call from a lovely lady named, I don't know if she's a lovely lady, I assume she is just one of our viewers, Ellen Haynes, who claims she is the next door neighbour of the child in the choir boy footage. That choir boy apparently is Jonathan Day, the mystery choir boy. I repeat, Jonathan Day. If you're there, Jonathan, get in touch with us. We're going to track you down either way. get on board the train. Okay, thank you very much. Here to talk to us about what's going on in the house today is lovely Wendy. I understand there's been a bit of unrest today, Wendy.
Yeah, there has. The after the nominations, I think Tim and Alex have managed to sort of separate themselves from the other three, and there's been a bit of an atmosphere. So Johnny decided to take the bull by the horns, and he said to Tim, what's your problem, basically? And there's a bit of an atmosphere there, and there's a divide. And Tim responded by saying that it wasn't his problem and it was Alex's problem.
I don't want this show to be anti-Tim, but that's outrageous.
Yeah.
Okay.
And Kate joined in as well, and sort of had her say as well. So.
Tonight's party. Do you think that will resolve the differences? I mean, we're all going to be in a very, very small room together.
Well, actually, they've had a few drinks and they've got, you've probably seen their sort of dressing up clothes and they've all got them on, and they do seem to have managed to forget the differences, and Tim and Alex are both dressed up in their outfits and they are joining in, and it does actually seem to be a much happier atmosphere all round. So.
All right, I think we can see that now, and hopefully they'll be resolving the differences tonight. Thank you very much, Wendy. Okay, before we ask Mina what she thinks is the funniest housemate, because there has been a lot of jokes going on lately, here's a few attempts at comedy so far.
Housemates, this is Davina.
This is Davina.
You are live on Channel 4.
Please don't swear.
Please do not swear.
Hello. Hi. We're the Fane Twins.
Like a giant
gypsy.
How you doing?
Do you fancy doing some training today?
How are you today?
I'm good, and you?
We're great! We're making a campfire!
Because all you men out there are scumbags.
I'm going for identity crisis.
So, guys, what do you reckon? Comedy geniuses or just a lot of people like playing the fool? You don't answer.
I think Kate likes playing the fool. She's very aware, though.
Yeah.
Her comedy is kind of... She knows that she's doing stuff. And she knows that people will watch. Whereas the other people, like Johnny and stuff, I just think they're very natural. They don't know they're kind of funny. They're just funny. And Alex... Oh, it makes me laugh a lot.
He's fairly funny, this little fella.
Peter's very funny.
Look at him, isn't he cute?
But it's that thing of people who don't know that they're funny and just do funny things, you know, without playing up.
Right, okay, we've got three hilarious jokes that the housemates have come up with during the time in the house. We're going to play them to you minus the punchline. All you have to do is guess what that punchline might be. Before we begin, I should warn you, they're not the best quality, i.e. they're not actually funny. Okay, first up, PJ with his effort. Take a look.
What's big white, and if it fell out of a tree and hit you, it'd kill you.
Polar bear in a fridge on his way to the loo.
In a fridge. Take a look.
A fridge,
yeah, you're right.
Come on. Oh, no, that's very
sad. I like
sad.
The fact we've given you too much time on this.
That's a bit sad, actually.
Polar bear in a fridge. I like that.
That's rubbish. That's not even funny. It's not even a joke.
I'm going to sit in the middle here just in case this rouse and eruptions.
Is that like Brummy humour?
Easy.
Yeah,
guys.
Probably, yeah.
Secondly, we have Johnny the Joker Regan. Take a look.
What's yellow and jumps from cake to cake?
Zebedee, covered in custard.
No.
What do you reckon?
It's Tarzan, isn't it?
Take a look.
Tarzipan.
Tarzipan?
Actually, that's quite funny.
However, asking PJ his answer isn't particularly fair, seeing as though he lived in there.
Oh, sorry,
No, that's cool.
Hang on.
And finally, this little gem from Kate.
What's the fastest cake in the world?
A meringue.
It's a scone.
A scone?
Yeah.
But that's really old.
Go on, humour me, have a look.
Scone.
It's so funny in there.
You see that? That was a tumbleweed moment.
It was, wasn't it?
It was.
Token round of applause for PJ for getting him right.
Yay! He should.
Said token! Okay. So, last question. Bad jokes aside, funniest housemate in there?
I used to like Alison. She used to make me laugh. And Alex. Johnny, I love Johnny.
You're now just listing the housemates.
Yeah, everyone. Okay. Everybody. PJ.
All right. Finally, on that one housemate must leave this Friday. Tim or Alex, hear the numbers. This week there are two people up for eviction. To evict Alex, dial 09011 154 01 or text vote Alex to 83188. or to evict Tim, dial 09011 154 05 or text VOTE TIM to 83188. Course cost 25p, lines close 8:35 on Friday. All right, earlier we asked you to call in with your ideas on what tasks we should have set the housemates. I say we, I mean Big Brother, because we're Little Brother. OK, Steve's back with us to comment on your efforts, and we should have Ruth in Lanarkshire. Hello, Ruth.
Hi, Dermot.
You're
right. PJ.
Hello, Ruth.
Ruth, what's your favourite task, and what would you set?
Well, I think that empty room that the disco shall be removed out of should have a bucking bronco.
Yeah.
That's a good one. Good Steve, one. What?
Yep, they get a chance to practice first. Then, at the end... The bucking bronco, they'll have a practice on it first. Then maybe every 5 seconds, say. That'll lend so much towards the weekly budget.
Mm-hmm.
You've already got an empty room there anyway, you know. So,
what do you reckon?
Yeah, that's going to be all about mutual accountability. If they're all going to benefit, they're going to be giving that person on the booking bronco maximum support, maybe coaching them a bit, giving them some skills, really rooting in there for them.
Yeah,
that's the sort of behaviour that'd be good.
Out of the guys that's left, who do you reckon would be the best at sort of like bucking bronco riding style?
Alex.
Alex, you think Tim?
Yeah, I think he'd really go for that one. Show off his macho image.
Thank you very much, Ruth. Next up, Kev in Edinburgh. All the Scots ringing in today, I like this. Kev, what's your task?
Hello Dermot, how's it going?
Hello, you're right.
Good. Right, what you need to do is you need to set individual tasks for everybody, right?
Right.
And if they fail them, then you have to sit around the sofas and on the plasma screen show a piece of footage of that person speaking in the diary room, slagging off one of the exits.
Yeah, pretty confrontive stuff. You've got to know how to handle the results of all of that, and you'd need to have a really positive activity lined up afterwards to kind of bring them all back together. That would be very fiery.
That would set the cat amongst the pigeons. Yeah. Who do you think would have most to lose off the back of that peach?
Well, it looks like Tim, doesn't it?
Tim, I think. Because he wouldn't be able to tell people knowing his secrets. He's a bit secretive too.
Interesting. I like the fact we've kind of got criminal masterminds ringing in. Very impressive. Barbara in the Wirral. Or should I call you the Joker? Hello, Barbara. Go for it.
Hi, Dermot.
You're right.
Mine sounds a bit tame after all this. What I was thinking of, they could have a knitting competition.
Yep, right? You're right.
And the one who knitted the longest scarf could have a reward. And, you know, there's another side to it that, like, maybe Alex could get all these tie them together, throw them over the wall and escape.
You're just writing the script as we go, Barbara. Barbara, thank you very much. So I'd appreciate it. Thank you very much to all our guests today. Thank you, Steve. Thank you, Mina. Thank you,
Pleasure.
TJ. We are back tomorrow with Holby City favourite Jez Edward, 7 p.m. on E4. We'll see you then. Take care.